You only need two things. Maybe that. I've learned that we buy a lot of things that we don't need, that don't actually work, and we spend stupid amounts of money for it. These are all of the skincare products I found in my cabinets. I thought I had simplified it to three things, but obviously I have still been duped by marketing. It takes zero effort to take one wrong turn on social media and be bombarded with ads for fillers, masks, exfoliators, face exercises, massage tools, serums, and the rest. But I keep thinking to myself, what are we trying to achieve by buying all of this stuff? Is it to have that perfect porcelain plastic kind of looking skin that we see on magazine covers, which have been heavily edited, creating unrealistic expectations about how our skin is supposed to look? Is it to try to look 15 again? I don't want to look 15 again. My face was a pizza. Leaving aside the fact that skincare companies make a huge profit out of our insecurities, I really want to know, what do we actually need? And can we please stop wasting our money on things that don't actually work? How the heck are we supposed to know who to turn to and what to believe anymore? What I have learned so far, there are really only two things that I now pay attention to. The first one is board certified skin surgeons, that is dermatologists who specialize in skin care, who are not sponsored to sell beauty products or to sell you anything. And secondly, your actual experience in real life with your own skin and asking people who you trust how they're going with their skin, especially if it's similar to yours. It was actually a real world experience that I had a few years ago that was an absolutely huge wake up call. And okay, I'll just share the story. I'm probably not the only one that's gone to the gym and found somebody attractive. I saw this man working out and respectfully asked him, how do you wash your face? His skin got my attention and he was obviously doing something that was working. What did he wash his face with? Water. That was it.
Huh?
He wasn't using scrubs, foaming stuff, soap. He did say that occasionally he did use a gentle cleanser and not water, but most of the time he's washing his face with water. When he said that, not only was I by that stage looking microscopically at his skin, like a surgeon, and the pores of his skin, not creepy at all, Gemma. I had a mix of thoughts that were running through my head. Firstly, is he joking? Secondly, that's kind of gross. Don't you actually have dirt and stuff still on your skin after washing your face with water? And thirdly, have I been lied to my entire life about how to clean and take care of my skin? So his answer set me on the path to figuring out why I spent so much money on cleansers and skincare when my skin too could look that good for doing a lot less, and what actually is the best way to take care of our skin. We're all probably across this by now, but beauty influencers are selling you something, and celebrities often don't just do what they say they're doing. For example, olive oil is not actually going to give you a facelift and doesn't actually lift your skin. I've dealt with pretty bad acne when I was growing up, and it really came down to only one product that fixed it. But of course, when my acne journey came to an end, then I suddenly became the prime target of the anti-aging market. Marketing, making you feel shit about something that's completely natural, labeling it a problem, then selling you a product to solve that created problem. Except it doesn't actually fix the problem, and you end up poorer both financially and self-esteem wise. Going back to my too long didn't watch opener at the beginning of this video, do you only need water to clean your face and Vaseline for the moisture part of it? Yes, is the short answer. I have actually been doing this for the last few years. This is what my skin looks like. I have tinted SPF on my face and mascara. This is currently my face. I've got a series of photos I'm going to pop up on the screen. You can have a look at my face with zero, absolutely nothing on it. I literally washed my face and put Vaseline on it, and you can see what it looks like. You can see the pores on my skin. So there's no makeup, like there's no foundation. I'm literally running my hands over my face. You can see what's happening with my skin. I've discovered an amazing board certified skin surgeon who has literally changed the way I have understood skincare. Dr. Natalia Spearings. She's an American dermatologist. She's currently based in London, I believe. She flies between London and Dubai. She runs her clinics between those two cities. She sees patients, she cuts out skin diseases, fixes chronic skin conditions. She also dispels a lot of the myths that are out there in the beauty and skincare industry and what is completely garbage and what are scientifically backed. There's a whole language to studies that the layperson, the average person doesn't understand, including myself. I've had to learn what different levels of studies are, like, there are clinical, there are double blind studies, there are just anecdotal. Anecdotals is, it's pretty much you get somebody off the street saying, hey, pop on this cream, how does it feel? They can make a statement like, oh, my skin feels smoother. Oh, my wrinkles seem a lot less. That's gonna be an anecdotal statement that'll be slapped on the side of products. It has to be written by law with what this study entails. You see the very fine print, a little asterisk And they'll say, we tested it on 109 women. And they all said, 91% of these women said it made their skin feel more youthful. That doesn't prove anything. First of all, it's just a handful. It's not even a broad enough study. And secondly, that's just somebody's opinion. It's not actually scientifically backed. We don't know what the heck it's doing to the skin. So I could go down that whole rabbit hole. Let me just get to the... What I love most about Natalia is that she doesn't receive any money. She doesn't do sponsorships. She doesn't receive kickbacks for any product. Literally just says, this is what works. This is why it works. And I think I just really enjoy the fact that she has some ethics around the profession. She gets hit with so many offers to receive sponsorships, and we're talking huge brands. I couldn't imagine the hundreds of thousands of dollars she's turned down from deciding to not endorse brands because she wants to maintain a distance as a professional. She is quite active on Instagram, so go and watch her Instagram lives. She does interviews with people. She answers questions. She drops a Q&A, I think, every single week, and she will answer people's questions from rosacea, psoriasis, Botox, wrinkle treatments, hair loss, sun damage to the skin, cancer, age spots, cutting out moles and skin tags, whether rosemary oil actually stops you from losing your hair. Every time she dispels something, says, this is not true. There's five other things. It's like a hydra's head that's popped out. So now this actually helps you grow hair. Now this actually reverses aging, and it's all a load of bullcrap. There are no studies backing this up. So she kind of touches on all the latest gadgets and creams. Almost everything that you've bought and I've bought and that we all buy in skincare is pretty much full of it, except for a tiny handful of things you actually need, such as cleanser. Water is it. So my now friend wasn't lying. He was using water. I started using water and I thought, what the heck? Of course, if you wear makeup or dirt, you might want to use a gentle cleanser. And we're talking about super gentle cleanser, something you can buy from Chemist Warehouse, Priceline, Woolies, Coles. Cheap does the same as expensive. An often mentioned brand, CeraVe. It's because it's a very neutral, very gentle series of products, and it's cheap as far as skincare goes. Moisturizer, this one shocked me. Vaseline, or any thick, greasy, occlusive kind of product. Vaseline is as cheap as you can pretty much go, and it does the job as much as, like, if you look at La Mer, one of those very expensive hundreds of dollars in Mecca, you will see, if you ever see petrolatum, that is Vaseline. The hundreds of dollars that you're paying for what is effectively Vaseline is astounding.
There is Vaseline in virtually every single moisturizer you buy. It's pretty much in everything, because the other names for Vaseline are mineral oil, white soft paraffin, paraffin, petroleum, petrolatum. All these products are the same.
And before you ask, no, it doesn't cause acne, but don't take it from me.
It's very, very safe. It's not only hydrating, it's also antibacterial and also anti-inflammatory. It even seems to protect against UV damage, and it is the best at restoring a damaged skin barrier, better than any other product on the market. So when someone asks me what is the best moisturizer, I pretty much always say it's this one. And of course, everyone looks at me like I'm totally crazy, but it has a really strong evidence base, and there's a lot of science behind that.
Yes, it does leave that little sheen across your face. At nighttime, use a little bit more of a thicker layer. You're going to bed, you're not there to impress anyone, unless it's your job. And because it's leaving that little sheeny film across your face, there's a popular term being thrown around right now called slugging. Slugging your face. Face slugging. Variations of that word. Gonna slug my face. It just sounds like baseball bat. The slugger. Gotta do that to my face. Violent. The whole point around it is you want to stop the moisture from leaving your skin. That's what keeps your skin moisturized.
Moisturizers don't really moisturize. What they do is they create a barrier to water loss. So hydration has to do with the amount of water in your skin, and that's in your stratum corneum and in your viable epidermis. So basically the epidermis, the top layer of your skin. Hydration is about having water in there, and the best way to get water in there is to trap it in there, so to stop it from leaving the epidermis. So what an occlusive moisturizer does, or emollient, like this one, is it creates a layer that blocks that water loss, and that's how it hydrates.
You don't need a lot. It's like a tiny little bit on your pinky, like that much probably, I'd say. I'll be able to show you in the video. Wash your face, pat it dry, and before it starts to get crusty dry, pat on the Vaseline, only a little bit, that's it. And finally, sunscreen. The sun is the number one factor, the number one thing that accelerates aging in our skin. covering up is going to be your cheapest sun saver. Or just be like me and don't go out. Especially don't go out in the sun in the worst part of the day in Australia and New Zealand and anywhere there's an ozone problem. The worst parts of the day in Australia are between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. That's the highest level of UV. There's one additional extra thing that is mentioned by a dermatologist. There is only one product, one that has been tested and trialed and has the results and the scientific backing that is actually a product that will help your skin as you age. Tretinoin. It's in the retinoid family, so you will often see there are variations of strengths of this category. You will see some pretty common brands, anything you can get over the counter that says vitamin A, retinol. These are not going to work. They're the weaker version. Brands like L'Oreal, Olay, Roc, and so on. It's the stronger retinoid family member that you want. And that, unfortunately, is prescription only from a doctor. Now, you can go online. There are online script services and doctors that you can request the script through. Because I've had a history of acne and it's great to maintain the skin if you're going to have outbreaks, I think it's $15, $20 for a script. I will link a site that I've used below so that you can also grab it. I think it'll give you a discount. I'm not here to make money. I'm just like chucking the information out there, but you can literally Google Online Doctor Australia prescription, and then you have to fill out all your details. This is the hardcore product. It will make your skin flake. I think the one that I'm using is currently 0.05%. The brand of the cream is called Retrieve. It is the only scientifically shown product which has the, it's kind of like the, what's the hair loss treatment? The minoxidil is the only scientifically backed product for hair loss. Everything else is a load of BS. I mean, might feel good, you might think you're stimulating, but it's just, it's not scientifically shown to actually work. So there's so many, I should do one on hair loss too, because it's really interesting, particularly for those who are going through a hair loss cycle or maybe post baby delivery or middle age as well. Anyway, it's a whole thing. Might actually do it. Let me know if you're interested in a video on that. I spent so much money on so much stuff and I'm like, this is what I've learned. Here, have at it, do your own research, have fun with that. What the Retrieve cream or the any brand that's called different brands, but in Australia it's called Retrieve. What that hardcore retinoid family member actually does, the prescription only treatment does, is it not only increases the cellular turnover, it reduces the sun damage and pigmentation that you already have. It helps reduce the fine lines on your face because you've sloughed off the old skin cells. You're increasing that turnover, which gives you that lovely fresh look. And so it also means that it takes time and consistency to start seeing results. You can't use it for a month and go, yeah, okay, I'm good. It's like forever for the rest of your life. Science! As someone who had acne as a teenager and young adult, the first time I was able to use any moisturizer was in my 20s, because before then my skin produced so much oil that it was a film on my face 24/7 and nothing worked to help with that. I could literally run my hand over my face, show somebody and be glistening with oil. That's how bad it was for me. So I never used moisturizer until I was in my 20s. It wasn't until I was prescribed Roaccutane, again from my specialist doctor, which cured. That was the thing that actually cured my acne. Something floating around. I was prescribed that at the highest dose allowed because I could tolerate it very well. I didn't have any of those horrific side effects. I had dry skin. Yes, of course, it did flake. But I didn't suffer from any of those other side effects. Like people, there were claims that people were depressed and suicided. And so it really copped a bad rap, but I suffered nothing. And it's a pill. You swallow the pill with food. Nobody that I knew who took it had any side effects like that either. So I don't know whether it was a media blowout on certain cases and so it made everybody afraid of it, but it was the best thing that I've, I mean, I've still got acne marks because I had the pock marks, as you do. If you've had the hardcore nuclear level acne, which is hereditary, it's hormonal, you can't do anything about it in terms of using all the things that you're sold to use. So I did it. I did the celebrity endorsed Proactive. I tried tea tree oil. I tried Pfizer Hex, Coal Tar Soap, Clearasil, Neutrogena. I did everything. Nothing worked. That was the only thing that worked. I have spent my fair share of money on products that haven't worked. What about the latest collagen creams? Nope. It's a gimmick. Imagine me putting a sirloin steak on my butt because I want to grow a butt muscle. That's how you get the idea. Pretty silly, right? Same with collagen creams. Your skin is best served by leaving it alone. Just ignore it, almost. Because we have been sold on 14-step skincare. No, you don't. you can end up developing irritation and inflammation because you're doing too much. The less you do, the better it is. Red light therapy devices. I want to actually road test these and maybe do a 30-day testing thing and throw out the results to you because it interests me and I wonder, do these things actually work? Will I see anything? Are they worth the investment because they cost hundreds of dollars? Or are they another fad tool done by marketing companies to make a lot of money? And then you just sit there going, yep, I still look like crap. If you have also been feeling a little overwhelmed with the choices out there in terms of skincare, I'm starting to think it's really worth examining another question, which is, what will it actually take for us to feel comfortable in our own skin?